Semester of school. Now, when I say last semester, it's just of undergrad, because I am planning to go to grad school. It just wasn't the grad school that I expected to go to when I entered college. I finally decided what I want to do when I grow up. And I'm making that decision at 22 years old, which is okay. That is good, honestly. Some of the most interesting seminary. I am going to be a possible pastor in the future, and I'm going to go on staff with my church. And I think most of you maybe knew that or knew that I was thinking about doing that, but it's a pretty much final. I pretty much gave my verbal commitment. So I'm super duper excited. I got one more semester of exercise science, and then I'm going to go get my master's in church planning. So So I stopped doing the skincare routine. I was exfoliating and using face soap and moisturizing. And dude, I don't know if I will ever try it again. So that was kind of funny that I actually tried to do something to clear something up, and it backfired. So I'm going back to my old water in a rag method. So in my last video, I started talking a little bit about my online dating experience. It's probably like 20 minutes in, so I don't know if you guys might have made it that far, but I'm not done talking about it. There's just some funny things that I need to call out. I gotta expose it. So I downloaded
Bumble.
I downloaded
Tinder.
I downloaded
Hinge.
Tinder. And then Tinder was absolutely terrible. I hated it even more than Bumble, because on Bumble, I feel like you can actually get a good gist of the person, of who they are and what they're about. Tinder, you have no idea. It's pretty much just pictures. If you think they're attractive, then you swipe right. It's the same concept. And you can't see on either of those apps who likes you, you know, unless you want to pay a lot of money. So Tinder was a big no.
Hinge.
And by far, Hinge has been a delightful experience. You can actually see the people that are interested in you, and it enables you to actually spit some game, you know, let me work. You can like somebody's picture, and then you can actually leave a comment on that picture, you know what I mean? So I like that aspect of it, that you can see who likes you. And you can comment on somebody's picture, and then if they either thought, you know, and then they can like you, and they can match you, they can see that, okay? But this is what I think is odd, and what I've noticed about dating apps, it is that probably 80% of women give absolutely no effort, and it might be that way with men, like they just don't give any effort. Initiate the conversation. Every single time a woman has initiated a conversation with me, it's been, hey, hi. That's it. It's like most of the time, majority of the time, that's all I get. Hey and hi. If a man were to slide in a girl's DMs and say, hey, hi, how many hey's and hi's are they getting back? Probably not very many. So when a girl asks me, initiates a conversation and says hi or hey, I simply just say hi or hey back to them until they ask a question or they seem somewhat interesting, because I'm not gonna let you just say hi and then me have to do the work, you know. I want to see if you're interesting, see if you can initiate a conversation, because I know I can. I literally went back and forth with this girl. She says hi, I say hey. She said hello, I say howdy. She just stops. It's really just entertainment for me. And I know some of you guys out there are probably saying it's a man's job to initiate conversation, and it is most of the time, and I have no problem doing that. But I just think that is such an odd, just funny pattern that I'm seeing over time. But in general, I've been enjoying my experience. This is not like a sponsored video or anything. It's just my experience. I've been doing it like the last 2 weeks. So there's that.
It's time to talk music.
Eminem has dropped another Boo Boo Doo Doo album. I really have no expectations for him anymore. I'll say that he did have a couple decent songs on his last album, but in general, it still wasn't a good album. And the album before that was probably one of the worst albums I've ever heard in my entire life. Probably right behind Speeding Bullet to Heaven by Kid Cudi. Oh, man. I gave it 2 listens through. 2 listens. And, man, it's, you know, of course he's like a lyricist. His flow is definitely unique compared to anybody else. But just the overall vibe and the energy that I get from his music,
I'm just not happy with it. It's not the kind of music that I want to vibe to.
And it's as simple as that. The beats are trash. It literally sounds like something that I personally have made on GarageBand. Fun fact, I made a mixtape a little over a year ago, and I only pass it out to my closest friends, so that's going to be worth a lot someday. Mac Miller's new album came out, and I'll have to say, I absolutely love it, love it, love it, love it. I have listened to it a lot, specifically in the morning. I just feel like it's a great album to fry an egg to, you know what I mean? To put a bagel in the toaster, you know? It's sad, for sure. And that kind of leads into one of my topics that I want to talk about. You know, I was going to talk a little bit about life and something that I've been trying to do to help myself be a better human, better friend, and better family member, you feel me? Listen up, people. I really think that it is important to just tell the people that you love them. Tell the people that you're around. And the people that you love, tell them that you love them, actually. It's just so important. And I feel like if people actually told Mac Miller how much they loved him, I don't think that he would be dead right now. I know that he overdosed. He had himself. He's trying to live whatever's going to wake him up. You know, he wants to be woken up. He doesn't want to be part of this society. Anyway, super interesting. I will definitely talk about that next time in my whisper video, because I am not a fast reader and I don't read all the time. So go me.
Let's talk about movies.
So last night we drove, we as in me, Andy, Nick, my roommates, his family, or I should say his brother Trey, who has already been on this channel, and a couple of our other friends. We fit 8 people in a van and we drove all the way down to Indianapolis, Indiana. And they are one of the, they have one of the very few true IMAX movie theaters. Apparently all IMAX theaters aren't created equal. Some are LIMAX. And I guess the resolution or something is different. Maybe they're not as big, but my friends are huge, 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 huge movie buffs. Really, really into cinematography and editing and stuff like that. I'm getting there, people. I'm getting there. So we drive all the way down to Indianapolis from Toledo, Ohio. So I had to drive down and then over to Indiana. And I think I drove myself about 4.5 hours to go see this. We went to go see 1917. So I personally think that this movie is going to go down in history as one of the greatest movies of all time. I'm serious. The way that this movie is shot is absolutely beautiful. There are scenes and just shots that are literally like breathtaking. They're so beautiful. And there are scenes that you just don't know how it's shot, how they were able to do it, because they made the whole thing look like one entire take. And I guess, I don't know everything about it. I'd love to see a documentary talk about how that movie was shot, but I don't understand how CGI works. It honestly blows my mind. It's like magic to me. But the way that they use CGI made it look like it was one entire shot. Now, I know that a lot of it was one entire, was very, were, I know a lot of it were long shots. Was long shots. Talking's hard. But if you have not seen that movie, I would definitely go see it. I wouldn't say that the plot is incredibly interesting. I think it's good. I think it's definitely a good plot. And there is a part of the movie that you don't see coming. I'll let you know that. But man, just absolutely beautiful movie. The part of the video that I've been looking forward to, it's the new segment that I have created. It's called I'm Not Judgmental, But... So, I would consider myself a pretty non-judgmental guy, but there are just some things that people do that they deserve to be judged. So here, I got a couple of them. I got 3 of them for this video, and every time I think of one, I'm going to take a note and put them in my future whisper Ramblerer videos. So, my first one is, I'm not judgmental, but if you buy mild salsa, you deserve to be judged. Seriously, if you buy mild salsa, you deserve to be judged. Skittles 1x1, I don't. The second one, I'm not judgmental, but if you don't piss in the shower, you deserve to be judged. Honestly, I know this is going to be controversial, because I know a lot of people don't piss in the shower, but I believe that you don't piss in the shower because you are scared that people are going to judge you if they know or if they figure out that you pissed in the shower. You are that insecure. Just take a piss in the shower. You don't gotta piss on yourself. It's not gross. You don't gotta piss on your feet. Just piss down the drain, okay? I'm very passionate about this. Piss down the drain and nobody's got a problem, okay? The third and final, I'm not judgmental, but is if you read Snapchat news religiously. I hate Snapchat news. I honestly believe that it is going to be the demise of a generation. I think that it is causing people to care about things that they should not care about whatsoever. Now, I will admit that Snapchat news has gotten better. I occasionally browse it. I'm not gonna lie, I browse it because Snapchat news was Demi caught naked again. When people say that drugs fry your brain, that is exactly what Snapchat news does to people. So, that is my new segment. Let me know what you think. I'm going to keep working on it. It's a work in progress. That is the end of this video. Go to wrap it up. Hopefully you guys like the editing. I've put a little bit more effort into it. I got some new software. Super stoked about it. Got some new equipment for the setup. Super stoked about that. So, have a good night. And I just really hope that you guys wake up in the morning. This is Sufficient Whispers signing off. Peace out.